think it's absolutely fabulous to see so many people here, some very, very old faces, pardon me, of lots of, we were just talking about lots and lots of memories going flooding through here. But I'm not going to speak too much. I'm going to hand that over to Robin, as he normally speaks the longest. So I'm going to bring the time, the habit of a lifetime, so I'm going to hand over to Robin.
Yeah, good evening. It's ladies and gentlemen sounds so formal, doesn't it? There's a heck of a lot of friends in front of us here. There's colleagues who we've worked with, friends who we've met over the years, students who've become friends, and it's always a joy to meet people from Heworth. There is something about, and I quote, Heworth people, and the gentleman who kind of tagged that line was Harrison Huddart, our head of a number of years, who's now trying to disappear. And he said that about Heworth people. Well, Phil had to be a Heworth person. He joined the school in 75, I joined in 74. And we kind of hit the ground running with productions right from that point. For, as Elaine said, for over 38 to 40 years of productions. And even into retirement, Phil was still working with the school and with the youngsters. And I think he got the same sort of enjoyment that I certainly did, and certainly do, in still working with young people, because there are so many fantastic young people who've gone from Heworth Grange to do a whole range of exciting things across the world. I was at a concert, as was Elaine, the other night at the Customs House, and there in front of us, we didn't realise this was going to be the case, because we certainly knew one person who was performing, but there in front of us were four students from Heworth Grange singing in a concert at a super, super high standard. And that's just one concert in the northeast of England, and there's four students appearing there. There's certainly all four of them are here this evening. So that says something about the place. All these wonderful folks here on my right-hand side who are about to perform, and I hope all you people here are here to have enjoyment and have fun tonight with a smile on our face. That's what tonight is about. Tonight is about, yes, it's a celebration, absolutely. So when you celebrate something, hopefully you've got a smile on your face. We'll all have our moment, we'll all have our thoughts at some point for our contact with Phil. Normally, mine was, as you might hear on a clip on the video, was to come into school in the morning and to be met by Phil, sit down, have one of the copious cups of coffee that we'd have and leave half drunk during the day around the stage, and for him to say to me, can you build a pond? Why, in the garden? No, in the school hall. It's not the sort of conversation that many teachers would have with their colleagues on a regular basis, but it happened more than once. And it was that sort of enjoyment, that sort of sense of being pushed, actually, to think about what could be achieved with all the fantastic students that have come through the school. Now, Phil did have a habit, especially in concerts, of talking a lot. Anybody who has been through the concert experience with Phil will know that if you didn't know anything about the song before you started, you would have a full resume by the time you were finished. So on that note, I'm not going to talk for too much longer, because I sense there's probably a bit of a bet going on somewhere in amongst this one as to exactly how long I'm going to talk for.
30 seconds more.
Okay, I'll try that. So anyway, at this point, what we've done, and you'll all be able to see this bit up on the top of the wall there, It's just one of the things that, I mean, Phil had a lot of phrases. Some of them we didn't dare put up on. Normally about the cast who have not achieved well enough in a rehearsal, and he'd step up to the front of the stage and smack his hand on it and say, get off and do it again. And this time, better. He usually did. We all usually did. So a spot of rehearsal, anyone? Just something else that he would say on a fairly regular basis throughout the shows. Now, this tonight is a night of no expense spared. Because this is not a cheap... This high-quality piece of equipment here on my left-hand side is covering the serious reason for us standing here and not going straight into the theatre. So at this point, I'm going to ask Richard if he would like to say anything, and then operate this really, really good bit of kit that's going to reveal something that I hope you will all appreciate. So, Richard.
Well, as Robin said, I don't think I'm going to be able to match up to my dad's aeration skills. I'd just like to say thank you so much. It's a pleasure to see so many faces here, a lot that I know, a lot that I don't know. It was really part of my, although I didn't go to school here, it was part of my life coming here every time that my dad was putting something on, and it was a real pleasure. And tonight I can't think of any more fitting tribute than this. So thank you guys, I really appreciate it.
Right, with great care.
Were crafted with all the loving care and attention to detail he could muster. I have lost count of the hundreds of positive messages I have received from parents and other visitors who have been to see a show here and were in awe of the sheer professionalism and splendour of it all. Many of the people here tonight will have been a part of Phil's legacy, both within these walls and beyond them. Phil was a wonderful man, a great colleague and a special friend to many here. And ultimately, this is what we miss most. The warmth, good humour, passion and spirit of the man we all knew. Tonight, his colleagues and friends will pay tribute to him in the way they know best and in the way he would have appreciated the most, by once again demonstrating that his creative spirit lives on in those who still make his legacy real every day in our school. Think of Phil tonight, and as I am certain he would have said himself, enjoy the show.
my name's Jamie Brown, and I was at the school during the 90s into the early 2000s. And Phil didn't introduce me to theatre, but he introduced me to the idea that a lad from Lean Lane Estate could do it as a job and could follow a dream, and it was something that he could pursue. And on that video there, I was filming the trailer for the next instalment of the stage adaptation of When the Boat Comes In, which goes out this August, which is something that I just simply would not be doing if it wasn't for Phil Welch. And it's my pleasure to be here speaking tonight, unexpectedly, to introduce the first song, which I think is going to be Rhythm of Life. Yeah. Lovely, enjoy.
In Newcastle in the King's Hall there, where John Rutter himself was going to be delivering a workshop, I suppose, where he was going to be conducting a few of his pieces. So Phil and I were like, right, we're going to go, and actually be part of it, a big SATB thing. And then unfortunately Phil wasn't too well, but I still went along, I'll go along and I'll be able to tell him all about it. And this piece I actually heard for the first time there. So Look to the Day, which is the piece, was written, and actually at the invitation of Cancer Research, for the service of Thanksgiving in 2007. It's a tuneful, uplifting piece, nice harmonies, nice anthem. And the words written by John Rutter project a strong central message of hope, I think. Ideal, I think, for tonight's celebration of Phil's life. The inspiration he was to so many, and to the future musicians and performers that will no doubt continue to come out of Heworth Grange as a result, pretty much, of his legacy. So this is Look to the Day by John Rutter.
Hi, I'm Claire Taylor. I'm about to sing Not While I'm Around from Sweeney Todd. It is a wonderful song between Toby and Mrs. Lovett, all about protection. And the reason I chose this song is because to me that's what Phil was as a teacher. He protected us, he gave us something to strive for, he pushed us, he challenged us. Phil is the reason why I'm a teacher. I've been a teacher for many years, but he's also the reason why I still perform. I perform in societies around the region. This song comes from the show, as I've said, Sweeney Todd, where I played my first lead principal role as Mrs. Lovett. So for that, Phil, thank you. Here is Not When I'm Around from Sweeney Todd.
Hi everyone, thanks for coming tonight to honour Phil. I'm Ryan and this is Stephen, and tonight we're going to be singing Agony from the musical Into the Woods. This is one of the many musicals that me and Stephen have been involved with, one of Phil's fantastic shows. We've been in My Fair Lady, Les Miserables, Scarlet Pimpernel, to name a few. Just want to thank Phil for everything he did for us. He's such a great man, and he's got me into my love of drama and the art and theatre. It's a funny song. I play Rapunzel's prince, and Stephen plays Cinderella's prince. We're kind of love struck with the princesses at the time, and randomly in the middle of the woods, pouring out our hearts with a funny song. So I hope you enjoy it. This is Agony from Into the Woods.
use her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach. High in her tower she sits by the hour, retaining her hair, blithe and becoming, frequently humming a light-hearted air. What's out of reach? Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, and heir to a throne? You are everything maidens could wish for. Then why don't you? I know the girl must be mad. You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair. Somewhere up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her. I'm always 10 feet, no, and she's just out of reach. Agony that can cut like a knife. I must have her to
Good evening, everyone. I hope you're having an enjoyable evening. My name is Colin Skipsey, and my claim to Phil is that I've known him probably longer than most of the youngsters that are surrounding me on the stage tonight. Over 40 years, Phil was a young teacher when I first met him, and I was still at school. Goodness, yes. He gave me my first opportunity in doing a bit of theatre, which I appreciate. I'm still doing it now. So without him, I wouldn't be enjoying this evening and many evenings like it. So the next morsel for you to chew on is a song from the production Scarlet Pimpernel. It's called When I Look at You, and it is sung by the marvellous Nicky Pearson.
Look at you, you're standing there. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is David Wilson. I'm a former pupil here at Heworth Grange Comprehensive. I first met Phil when I was about 12 years old. Very shy pupil, went along to a musical theatre audition with my friend, not thinking I was going to do it, and he coaxed me into singing for the part of Oliver, which I got. And from then on, I was in loads of musicals throughout my school career, and from that, Phil influenced me to go on to be an actual full-time professional musical theatre performer in London, and I managed to travel the world, meet my wife, and have three beautiful kids. So as an influence for getting me started, he was very, very much a key figure in that. Well, anyway, enough about me. The boys and girls in the choir are going to sing a beautiful song for you now, and I know it was one of Phil's favourites. So here is Anthem from Chess.
Of working with a friend over a huge range of productions. Who else can go into work in the morning, meet a friend, and be asked to build a pond in the school hall? Lots of memories. This one, O Fortuna, from Orff's Carmina Burana.
Right now. people know about Phil's contribution to the drama department at Heworth Grange, and of course all the shows that he worked on, but not as many people know about his contribution to the media studies department. In 1999, Phil was my media studies teacher, taking over from Tony Cox after he emigrated to America. Phil was a great teacher. He allowed us the space to get creative and, of course, let me borrow the kit that we needed to play around with. This culminated in our masterpiece A-level media practical project, the Coxbridge Project, which co-starred a great man himself. Enjoy.
Excuse me, I'm having an interview with you.
What about?
I'm doing a documentary about Tony Cox.
Oh yeah, I knew him. Yeah.
It's about the legend of the Coxman.
Oh, it's an absolute load of rubbish. Absolute load of rubbish.
I tell you, don't believe in this.
Absolutely not. He just moved away for a new job. Well, what's more likely, well, that he moved away for a new job?
Well, wait a minute. There's quite a few stories going around here, so...
Yeah, but it's a school.
Are you calling these people liars? These...
Yeah.
Which? Wait a minute. Are these people lying?
Absolutely, I think they're lying, yeah. It's a school, there are stories around the school all the time, you know.
My father died of Coxrock. Good day, you see.
Just easy, he's just moved away for a new job.
So you don't believe any of the stories?
Not at all. Not
Cox
in the slightest.
Someone slapped my face.
No. Absolutely ridiculous. He left to get a new job. I can give you his address.
Just shut up!
Today I run my own video production agency with my business partner who was in the same class, and we're making TV commercials and online videos for companies all over the UK. Phil played a huge part in inspiring us and many others at the school, and for that I'll be forever grateful.
Hi, I'm Lisa, and I met Phil in September 1994 at the tender age of 11. Phil, you were a massively, massively positive influence on my life, more than you'll ever know, so much so that one of my children is named after you, and my years in the youth theatre were genuinely some of the happiest years of my life, so thank you so much for that. I also met my best friend Sarah in the youth theatre, and Phil used to use our friendship as a model example to other students whenever there was falling out or bickering, which was nice. So I would now like to introduce Sarah to sing your next song, which is Sending the Clowns from A Little Night Music by Mr. Stephen Sondheim, who is another one of my heroes. Enjoy.
Lost on the ground, you Hi, my name's James Taylor. I was a relative late comer to the youth theatre, joining in 1998. And in 2004, we were all really excited to hear that the summer show that year would be Les Miserables. And I know that Les Mis was one of Phil's favourite shows, and it'll be my honour to perform Bring Him Home for him tonight.
And I'm going to be singing the Flower Duet from the opera Lakmé. Today I'll be singing it with Jenny Scantlebury, but we have both sung it in concerts before, just not with each other. It was a favourite of Phil's because not only did he have a love for musicals, but also a bit of the old plinky plunk on the piano.
Thank you. I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood. Hello there. Craig here. Foz here. First of all, this screen looks familiar. First of all, I do apologise that I'm not there tonight with you guys on stage, my fellow Youth Theatre alumni, to pay a tribute to the great man, legend, that is Phil Welch. I'm sure we all have great, many fond memories of Phil over the years, you know, of the many summer productions and concerts that we've done. One such memory for me was during rehearsals for the old Curiosity Shop, and there was myself, Stu, I think, Lindsay Davidson, on stage there, and we just couldn't get through the scene. Just corpsing, killing ourselves laughing. As you can imagine, Phil was getting a bit impatient by the whole process. And about after eight, nine, 12, who knows how many takes we went through of it, we got those immortal words from the man. Get off and do it again. Well, Phil, we're back on for you tonight. This next song is a personal favourite of mine from the musical Half a Sixpence, Flash Bang Wallop.
Captain Albert of the lost with all family posed around a bed with a baby and his mother. Prince Philip said to Wills, I say, he looks just like your brother.
I joined the youth theatre in 1994, when I was 11, when I started school, and the years following that, all throughout school, were probably one of the best years of my life. I learned so much from being involved in the youth theatre and the enthusiasm that Phil gave to the whole production of the shows and everything was really inspiring. I made some of the best friends in the youth theatre, and I don't think I'll be where I am now had it not been for those years spent with all of those people and at Heworth Grange School. So it's a really great honour to introduce the next song, which is Zadok the Priest.
So, in true Phil style, I thought I would give you a bit of a story, a bit of a waffle. I think I was 12 and I was in a practice room waiting for a guitar lesson, doing what I do. I was singing and playing and messing around. And in those days, the doors were double, so you could hear a door open before someone came in. And around the corner came a head, and that head belonged to Phil. And he asked me to sing because he'd been listening on the outside. And then I was asked to sing in a Christmas concert, and I did. And I sang Wind Beneath My Wings with my guitar in a Christmas concert. And at that Christmas concert, I first heard Zadok the Priest and was amazed and thought it was fab. And from then on, the rest is kind of history. I was taken into singing lessons. I got involved with the youth theatre, and all things music sort of started from there. And I think you could probably say that everything I've done to where I am now was shaped in some way by Phil, and I'll always be grateful for that. So I am going to sing tonight. I'm going to sing a solo, and I know lots of people have been singing things that he's asked them to sing, and I thought about it, but one of the things he gave to me was that you should be singing the things you want to sing, whether that be classical music, operatic music, pop music. So I'm picking a song that I wanted to sing. So although my song is not for Phil, it's something I've sung for Phil, it is for Phil, and tonight I'll be singing The Rose.
Some say love. In 2018, Phil asked me to sing a song for a concert that was supposed to happen in July of last year. Some reason, concert didn't happen. I went away to have a think of what I wanted to sing. I didn't want to do something that had been done umpteen times before. So had a scroll through YouTube, listened to quite a few songs, and came across this next song, which I'm about to sing. I sent it through to Phil. He replied, his exact words were, "Sounds pretty damn good to me, Rob." So here it is. It's a song from a Kate Kerrigan and Brian Laudermilk musical, Republic, which is based on Shakespeare's Henry IV, and it's called One Last Prayer.
Emily has just an absolutely phenomenal music teacher and pianist, and I'd just like to take this opportunity for all of us to say a massive thank you. Joining us at the piano tonight, we've got Buffy. Buffy, Phil was a bit partial to a bit of Buffy, so, you know, made an appearance here.
When I first met Phil, it really struck us how passionate he was about the arts and about drama and musical theatre in particular. I just rented a musical called The Old Curiosity Shop, and I was really wanting to get it put on. And Phil took the time and the trouble to actually take it away and listen to the completely unfinished redrafts of music, and he got really excited as well. And I'd seen him produce shows before, and I wouldn't have entrusted anyone else to do the job than him. He did a fantastic job on it, and he was so talented in what he did. Every single show had that sparkle, that edge. This particular song we're going to sing now is from his favourite show, and I still remember the time when he got the rights to do it. He's like a child in a sweet shop. He was so excited. And whenever he did this song in any concert, the introduction would actually last longer than the song itself. You would tell the entire story, but nobody minded because everyone loved to hear him tell stories. He was fantastic in that way. This is from Les Miserables, and it's called One Day More.
My crime will surely come a second time.
One day
I did not live until
today.
How can I live when we are parted?
One day more,
tomorrow you'll be worlds away.
And yet with you my world has started.
We'll meet again.
One more day.
Everything about it is appealing. want to, Foz here?
So I just say I'm going.
Robin Wilson.
Is a rendition of a song. Oh. Can you handle that?
No, you can't. Kev probably could, you know.
This is right out my comfort zone.
It's a running favourite of.
Sorry.
It's a composer.
PG.
She's done it before.
Robin Wilson. Robin Wilson.
Sorry.
Fine.
I'll do it. Ask it. Wait, can you do that again?
And really built us up to.
The next song, which is Sending the Clowns from a Little Mat. Yeah.